So, I rarely make vodka cocktails because I don't really like vodka cocktails. I mean, sometimes I have to do it at the bar, of course, but when I make drinks for myself, I rarely make a vodka cocktail at home. Except for today's cocktail. I like it, it's elegant, it's boozy, and it's one of the few martini-style cocktails that I actually do enjoy. And it doesn't hurt that it makes me feel like Bond. Johann Bond. How corny was that joke? Let's make the Vesper. The Vesper originates from Ian Fleming's book Casino Royale from 1953. If you haven't read the book, maybe you've seen the movie with Daniel Craig. This one.
Wait, 3 measures of Gordon's, 1 of vodka, 1/2 measure of quinoa lily, shake it over rice, and then add a thin slice of lemon.
Yes, sir.
It's a pretty good movie. Anyway, Bond names this martini Vesper after his girlfriend Vesper Lynn, who later on, and spoiler alert, betrays him and dies at the end of the movie. What a bitch. Either way, the cocktail is still around and probably will be for a while. By the way, I think Daniel Craig is one of the baddest James Bonds out there. Who's your favorite Bond? Okay, so we're gonna need a gin. I recommend a London dry style gin. I'm using Beefeater myself, but if you have Tanqueray or Bombay Sapphire or Gordon's that James Bond actually calls for, then go for that. But as long as it's a London dry style gin. A vodka, I'm using Tito's because Tito's is the only vodka I have at home and I don't really care about vodka. So also, I just wanna point something out that is really unique about Tito's. Tito's vodka is handmade, whatever the hell that means. But good for you, Tito's. Freaks. Apparently James Bond prefers Polish vodka, so I don't know, grab Belvedere if you can find it. And then Cocchi Americano. Cocchi Americano is a fortified, aromatized wine. And before some of you throw a fit out there now and saying, what is he doing? It should be Lillet Blanc. I'm gonna tell you this, no, it shouldn't be Lillet Blanc. It should be Quina Lillet, which is the original in the original Vesper recipe. But here's the thing, Quina Lillet is not being produced anymore. Lillet is, but they took out the Quina, and the Quina refers to quinine. And quinine is a bittering agent taken from the cinchona tree. I've talked about this in my gin and tonic video a while back, but today's Lillet Blanc doesn't have any quinine in it, but guess what does? Cocchi Americano, baby. And I also like to add a few dashes of orange bitters that I didn't put here. You're gonna start with 2 dashes of orange bitters, and I'm using Regan's orange bitters. ¾ ounce of Cocchi Americano. ¾ ounce of your vodka. And 1½ ounce of your gin. James Bond also asked for his martini to be shaken, not stirred, which is something I won't be doing. I will be stirring it. Because you stir cocktails like martinis and Manhattans and Negronis and old fashions, cocktails that are just clear ingredients without any citrus in there or any dairy or egg whites or anything like that. The reason for it is because when you stir a cocktail, you want to dilute it and you want to chill it, but you don't want to break up the viscosity of it. I don't know if breaking up viscosity is the correct terminology, but basically you want the texture of the cocktail to be silky. Whereas if you shake the cocktail, you will infuse air bubbles into the cocktail that will make it lighter, which is nice in certain cocktails, but not in a stirred cocktail. Let's give it a try. This is an excellent, straightforward martini-style cocktail. Pretty self-explanatory, but this is what I get. Like, you have the gin toned down a little bit by the vodka, and then you have the Cocchi Americano to bring a little bit of herbs in there and a little bit of bitterness from the quinine. I like the addition of orange bitters in there because it gives it a little bit more depth and a little bit of citrus, and then just a citrus peel on top to give you those fresh citrus oils. It's a good one. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next week. Toodaloo.